losses as well. So what do you think? Is he a dangerous opponent?
Yeah, very dangerous. He's a tough guy, you know. He's coming very well. And yeah, he take two losses last fight, but doesn't matter nothing, you know. I think he coming with a lot of hunger in this fight. He need to win, you know. He put the third loss in a row. It's bad for him. But realistic, I don't care what is good about for him. For I'm going to smash this guy, you know. I'm going to feel, make him feel a lot of pain, you know, for 15 minutes. You know? He's smart. Maybe he stay in the floor early.
Obviously, news came out about him being arrested for drinking on Thanksgiving. How did that affect you at all? I mean, did you see that? What goes through your mind?
I saw that in internet. I don't know if that's true or fake, but you know, I'm sitting and waiting. If somebody called me to say the fight is canceled, I thinking and they give me other opponent, you know, and I'm still fighting. For realistic, for me, nearly just only one step more for my belt. I don't really care about him, you know. And this is the opponent the UFC put for me. I say, okay, you know. But you know, my goal is the belt. You know, doesn't matter. Go inside the cage with me. I gonna smash. Yeah, I gonna go to my belt.
Nice. Last thing for me. What type of fight do you think we see? Do you think you can dominate and get him done early, or do you think it's gonna be another war?
No. Probably there's gonna be another war. You know, but I gonna finish him. You know, I know I gonna finish him.
Santiago, right here. I know you said you're focused on Jeff and you saw that thing on the internet and you don't know if it was true or not, so the fight is obviously happening. But when you see that headline, are you just wondering, like, what's going on in fight camp, considering that was so close to the fight when that news came?
Yeah. They call me some friend, you know. I don't watch very news, you know. But the friend called me and said, hey, you saw that? And nothing, man. I sit and say, okay, man, you know, the bad news is the first news you listen, you know. I say, okay, I'm going to sit in home, and probably if the phone talk between today, tomorrow, the fight maybe is canceled. But, you know, and in the right moment, I think, you know, hey, hopefully they give me other guy, you know, for stay busy. You know, this is the they're looking for now, you know, stay busy, stay fighting, you know. Yeah, thank God the fight is still on, you know. There's a good opponent. To show my word, to show who I am again, you know. I know I have everything to finish this guy. Yeah, I'm going to do this on Saturday.
Santiago right here. Santiago, for the, you know, the UFC Latino commentators, it's been a great year. Obviously, Brandon Moreno's done well, Chito. Does that give you some extra motivation? It just seems like this is a great year for all three of you guys.
No, of course, man. Last time when we fight, we three together, all three, we take a bonus in 1 month. You know, three victories, bonus, belt for Brandon Moreno. I think we come in doing a really good work, you know. I come in working in the UFC Spanish for so long, you know, then in 2015. I'm happy to see this department grow up, you know, it's coming growing. I'm very happy, you know, to be part of about that, you know. I really like, you know, the broadcasting, the fight, and all the people working with me there.
I asked Dominic Cruz, who's obviously the commentator in English, what's it like having the other guys listening to them commentate his fight? Same question for you. What's it like for you listening to your friends commentate your fights?
No, that's great, man. They have a lot of... They really like me, and I think that's very good. You know, my friend is there, you know, working on this fight, and yeah, I'm very excited. You know, that's a great card too. You know, there's two belts on the line. I'm behind the two belts. You know, that's a really good place to make sure my work. You know,
I asked Cruz. I want to ask you: do you ever text like Brandon or Chito after your fight, and you have to tell them, Brandon, that wasn't what I was trying to do in the cage? What were you saying in the commentary?
No. We always respect a lot, you know, when we fighting all of these guys, you know, we are professional. When we in the desk, we are very professional, you know. We pass a good information, but never put what we like in the microphone, you know. It always is about professional work.
Thank you and good luck.
Santiago, down to your left here. I don't know if you recently saw that Gunnar Nelson says that the only fight that he wants to come back and have is a rematch with you. Now, I know that was 4 years ago. Is that something that you're open to having?
Who said that?
Gunnar Nelson.
Is still fighting?
Yeah, well, he wants to have a rematch with you. He hasn't fought, I think, for nearly 2 years. I don't know. I can't
remember. He's still fighting?
Okay. Yeah, he's still fighting.
I think he rated it. But, man, why? I know come out in 82 seconds. Maybe him back to the top, and he's in between the top five. Maybe I can fight with him for go to the belt, or when I am champion, maybe I can fight with him. But what I gonna fight with him, man? I go in his home, and I knock him out in 82 seconds.
All right, thank you.
Santiago, tudo bom?
Beleza, como está?
Português.
Tudo bem?
Tudo bem.
Boa, boa.
Santiago, finalmente você vai ter o ritmo de luta, né? Desde 2007 você não fazia, se eu não me engano, três lutas no mesmo
Sim,
ano.
Sim, certo.
Você vai fazer agora. O quão importante é isso para você, para o seu estilo, para o seu tempo, para o seu dia a dia?
Eu estou bem, muito feliz com essa terceira luta. Eu queria fazer quatro. Quando eu saí minha luta com Baeza em junho, pedi para botar em setembro. Minha ideia é estar o mais ativo possível, recuperar o tempo perdido, realmente o sentimento de ter perdido 26 meses de minha carreira, estando no meu prime, no meu melhor momento de minha carreira, foi muito frustrante para mim. Ver muito cara que estava atrás meu no ranking, como Edwards, Luque, ou Bones, que nem estava ranqueado, passar na minha frente, ir pelo título, eu ser removido do ranking, foi realmente para mim uma frustração grande. E agora o que eu quero é estar ativo e poder mostrar o atleta que eu sou. Não? Então, graças a Deus, não pude fazer quatro, mas estou fazendo minha terceira luta. Estou conforme com isso e realmente estou no meu melhor ponto. Treinando muito bem a cabeça, mentalmente, fisicamente, estou muito bem. Então, estou pronto para fechar o ano com chave de ouro.
E é isso que a gente pode esperar em 2022 também, essa sequência, esse ritmo de lutas?
Sim. Se é por mim, cara, eu quero fazer quatro lutas em 2022, manter-me ativo e poder seguir representando a minha sangue, né, a pessoa da Argentina e toda a Latinoamérica.
Bom, você vai, esse duelo é o número 12 contra o número 14. Você acha que o fato de, no passado, você ter ficado muito próximo do cinturão, isso pode te ajudar, de repente, a cortar caminhos rumo ao cinturão?
Brother, ganhei 8 das últimas 9 lutas. Se eu ganhar nesse sábado, vai ser 9 em 10. Nocauteando 2 vezes o número 8 do mundo, ganhando de caras invictos com Mirga Baeza. Eu fui o primeiro em ganhar de Sean Strickland quando estava 15-0. Ganhei muito cara duro. Cara, 9 em 10. Procura ali e me fala quantos caras han ganado 9 em 10 e não han lutado pelo título. Ou seja, eu acho que o ranking a veces no faz sentido a posición que les dan, mas yo acho que estoy haciendo un buen trabajo dentro de la división.
Maravilha, más dos para finalizar, entonces. Sobre su adversario en sí, ¿dónde você ve una brecha, dónde você se acha superior, que você puede, en esa brecha, conquistar a vitória?
Yo soy más completo, ¿no? Yo soy un atleta más completo que él. Tem jogo de wrestling, tem jogo de chão, e incluso soy más técnico que él en la parte en pie. Entonces, tengo mejor movimentación que él. Yo acho que soy un atleta superior técnicamente y también físicamente, y también creo que soy superior con cuestión de experiencia. Entonces, yo creo que todo eso juega a mi favor.
Para finalizar, entonces, Santiago, quería que se explicasse en portugués, por favor, cómo fue esa cuestión, los rumores de que tal vez él no fuese a lutar, teve una prisión allí recientemente, cómo se llegó hasta usted y si de fato hubo alguna conversa, de repente algún nombre ventilado que podría sustituir él, o enfim.
No. Cuando vi la noticia, yo pensé, cara, tomara que él lute, ahí esperé si alguien ligara para dar más noticias, que pelo general son las que primero llegan y ninguém dio. Entonces, después fiquei más tranquilo, falei, no, entonces la luta va a rolar y. E não, depois aí não pensei em nenhum nome, eu falei, se ele não lutar, eu tomara que me botem alguém, né? Eu quero estar em ritmo, quero lutar e quero seguir meu caminho para o título. Como falei, para mim, ele é um escalão mais para ir em busca desse título mundial.
Santiago, o que não pode dizer de tu rival? Que sabe dele?
É um peleador frontal, um peleador com poder de nocaut, com uma mano esquerda perigosa, é um zurdo, patea fuerte también, es un peleador muy peligroso, especialmente cuando pelea con un guato de 4 onzas, sabemos que un golpe puede hacer la diferencia y ni siempre gana el mejor atleta, pero ese es el reto que representa Neil, por eso estoy emocionado con este combate, porque a mí también me gustan las peleas frontales, me gusta intercambiar golpes, soy mejor atleta que él en la cuestión técnica y lo voy a demostrar este sábado.
¿Ves diferente, preparas diferente, has aprendido
ves a los rivales diferentes porque ahora tienes que comentarlo? ¿Sientes que mejoras? ¿Cómo lo ves?
Sí, me gusta mucho el tema de estar estudiando las peleas. O sea, hace, como dije, bastantes años que estoy trabajando y estoy trabajando mucho. Entonces, estoy constantemente viendo peleas, analizándolas. De hecho, tengo la oportunidad de estar acá en vivo en las peleas. Y eso, sin duda, te va acrecentando como peleador, ¿no? Uno está desde otro ángulo. Aparte, está viendo todo tipo de peleas, femeninas, masculinas, todas división de pesos. Y eso va dando conocimiento.
Gracias.
De nada.